So I'm surprised we haven't heard a few F-bombs because you are on the highway, and I heard that's like your favorite place for cursing, if any, Bill.
Yeah, I tend to lose my mind here, but it's good. I'm going against the traffic right now, so it's fine. Sorry, the suspension on my truck sucks, so it's going to be shaking a little bit.
Hey, you have 4 nights here while you're in Phoenix. Are you gonna get some golfing?
I am, and I'm not a golfer. I go out there for the hang, and I go to watch other people losing their mind over the dumbest activity I've ever seen. And they're so into it, and I just love, oh my God, all of the ticks and all of this stuff people have as they're like addressing the ball. You got to stand there. It's like wait for Nomar Garciaparra to get back in the box, and then they still shank it. It's like just get up and hit the stupid thing. We're not playing for money.
I always think of that scene in Falling Downwards. Now you're gonna die in your stupid hat.
Yeah, exactly. So I go out there, I have a cigar, get my an Arnold Palmer, and I just sit there laughing because there's always my favorite guy is the quietly mad guy. Just you can see the back of his neck getting redder, which he each hole, and then he like feels like he needs to like he just wants to run up and just hit the ball again, so he's rushing. It's just watching people literally fall apart. It's hilarious.
Don't they always tell you to take up golfing to relax?
They
Take up
usually
golfing. It's very
say so
relaxing.
you don't get a heart attack, and then all of these ticking time bombs go out, join a club, and then they immediately rent a cart and start driving around the thing, and then at the turn they consume like 3,000 calories. It's like
Yeah.
of the unhealthiest people I've ever seen playing that air court quote sport, but it is a lot of fun.
Yeah, and Phoenix has some of the nicest golf courses, so it's beautiful. You said somewhere, and it might have been a podcast I heard this on, where you talked about how this generation needs a trio, a power trio. Now, Paul and I from,
Oh, yes.
I love that because where's Rush when you need him, right?
Yeah, anything. Green Day, any of these bands that just went out and, made you forget that you have no power in life.
Billy, I
So I
gotta.
watch them all the time. Or, it doesn't have to be a trio. AC/DC was great. Judas Priest, all of that. I mean, the kids are doing it today. It's just the music is different. It's, a lot of
Well, you're
chill music. I like that stuff. I'm a
a metal
psycho.
guy, right?
I like it all, man. I like, I'll tell you, is a killer new album out. Willow Smith, Jada, and what's his face? Will Smith's kid. Two tracks have been released. It's amazing. First of all, it's all in like odd time and it's pop music. So the first one I was listening to was like 4 bars of 7, 1 bar of 8, and then went into 7. The chorus was in 4, and it's killer. It's absolutely killer.
Are you a prog guy?
No, because I feel like they play in odd time because they're trying to, and they're just trying to make difficult music for the sake of it's like Mathletes rocking out. Not saying they all suck, but a lot of them suck. I did go see the other night. I went to go see it was Maynard from Tool's 60th birthday at the Hollywood Bowl, so it was Perfect Circle. Everything they play is in like 6 with Josh Freese, and then Primus. Christopher, all of these, it was incredible. Three incredible drummers.
Yeah, people don't know Billy. Billy's a drummer. Billy's a very, yeah, he's
Yeah.
an accomplished drummer. So when he starts calling out time signatures, then you start getting all the nerdgasm starts to come out. They're like, oh, are you a big fan of Gavin Harrison? What are your thoughts on Ian Paice?
Oh, there you go. Gavin Harrison, Porcupine Tree. Yeah, that's one everybody gets. I like some of their stuff too, but I'm also kind of a meathead, so if it gets too progressive. I'm always amazed at, what Malcolm Young did with like 5 chords.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, there are only 12 notes, Billy.
He found all of them, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
So Arizona Financial Theater is beautiful, but I have Paul in here purposely because I wanted to talk about this Fenway Park thing that you did that no one's ever done before. What was that experience like? What kind of mind trip was that?
That was so overwhelming. I had to like block it out and just sort of do it. But we got like a police escort going in. We went like into drove in to the outfield. I felt like I was in Led Zeppelin. And but I'll tell you this, they have the sound in the video screen so dialed in now that it was like playing just like a giant comedy club, you know. It was incredible. I still cannot believe I got to do it. And like, it's more now looking back on it, it's sort of blowing my mind. But as far as like, you know, to get through the performance, you can't get overwhelmed. Everyone, oh, you got to take it in. It's like, no, I don't. If I take it in, I'm going to shrink from it. So I just got to go out there and be like, okay, these people worked hard all week. They got sitters. They're here to laugh. They don't want to watch me be like, wow, man, that's the green monster. It's like, shut up, stupid. Make me laugh. So I made sure, you know, I got the job done.
Do you ever think when you were standing at the troughs between the fourth and fifth inning with the broken end of the trough at the end there and the urine just flowing down there with somebody else's doing their comedy show for you, that you would actually be there standing on stage and somebody else would be like, the comedian?
When I started out, the biggest thing you could do was be a headlining national comedian, like across the country. That was if you had like a hit TV show. You're like, oh my God, you can play the Comedy Connection in Boston and sell out six shows. It's like, it's insane. I'm really happy for younger comedians today because they have so much power. And it's funny, it's like, they're like comedians and business people all at the same time, which I don't think is a bad thing, especially the level of greed that's out there, whatever they can do to protect themselves. Like, I can't name one Taylor Swift song, but I am a huge fan of how she does business. She is like, it's a modern day Peter Grant. Where Peter Grant, before Zeppelin came around, the venue would take 90% of ticket sales and the band got 10. And he was the guy to come in like, right, they're not coming here to look at the roof. They're coming here to see Led Zeppelin. We're taking 90 or we're going somewhere else. And there was nothing they could do. They just had to be like, all right.
You think it was another Boston guy that did that when Dane Cook started, you know, when he was started using social media to sell tickets and stuff like that? You think that set the ball rolling for guys 100%. That come up now?
Dane was the one that showed the power of social media and having like, gonna make sure I don't hit this guy, a direct link to your fans. And I remember him like, you know, they were setting up all this morning radio for him to do to promote his tour. And he was going like, I don't need to do that. I don't need to go. Yeah, you do. And he goes, watch this. And he just, you know, said where he was going to be on MySpace. And he hit send and the place immediately sold out. Now the deal is everybody's doing it. So that's why I'm talking to you guys.
Well, thanks for taking that time. You know, you've taken it up a level beyond that, though, Bill. I mean, I had to watch Old Dad Again over the weekend. But then my husband, by the way, one of his
Nobody
favorite movies.
Nobody can get the name of that movie right. Old Dad. Mad Dads. It's Old Dads.
Cranky Old Man Dad.
Yes, yeah, whatever. As long as you saw it, I'm happy.
You know what I liked, though? I got to tell you, we don't have kids, but I watched Leo and I laughed my butt off. What a cute, adorable, just adorable. I loved it.
How great was that? Was the writing? The writing was all there. That was Adam Sandler and his whole group of people, and Robert Smigel, all of those guys. And one of the easiest, most fun gigs I ever had. And I actually got to get in one day in the booth with Adam Sandler, which everybody knows he's the nicest guy in show business, and he didn't disappoint. He's the greatest.
Well, we look forward to all of this. Four nights starting on the 25th, and the first three are sold out to see Bill Burr at Arizona Financial Theater, but you can still get tickets for the last night, and it is a great show. It's not Fenway, but it's Arizona, and it's best.
No. I love doing stand-up, and also I'm getting ready to do my stand-up special, so I'm at the top of my game, so you guys are going to get great shows. Guaranteed.
Billy, my girlfriend says that your wife is a bigger badass than you, not only because she was able to flip off one of the presidential candidates at a fight recently, but that she also wants to know when you get back to Canton and if you get a chance to see your family often.
Well, my wife is funnier than I am. She's more talented than I am. And better looking. We all know that. Do I get a chance? Yeah, not as much as I would like to. And, you know, most people have moved away and stuff. I will tell you, this building went up for sale out there. If I live near there, it used to be like one of those one-screen movie theaters. Like I saw Jaws and Saturday Night Fever there. And years ago, it sold. And, you know, they turned it into like businesses and stuff. And, you know, if I lived back there, if I was like maybe 15 years older, getting ready to retire, I would have bought it. And I just would have showed all the movies that I liked. Tarantino does that out here, man. It's awesome. He's got a couple of movie theaters and he just shows killer, killer movies. On Saturdays, he has cartoons and you buy the movie ticket and you get a free bag of popcorn with it. That guy's the best.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Netflix, Bill Burr is all over it. And Arizona Financial Theater, thanks for taking the time. And thank you for not crashing the car while we were talking to you.
Yeah, that would have sucked. Dude. Radio host caused death of comedian.
No. I am not a speed guy. I my Ferrari was a Ford F-250. Hey, I love this spec. No need for it. But I'll tell you, it has a three-pronged outlet in the back. And I went to the Rose Bowl this year and I was making cappuccinos and everybody around us was sweating our tailgate.
Hey, have fun while you're in Arizona. And thanks for taking time, Bill.
All right, guys. We'll see you. Thank you.
Take it easy.
Be safe, Billy.
Bye-bye.